Hi friends, welcome to the video lectures on technical C. Coming to the question number 41. So which of the following condition checks will print 10 twice? So before going into this question, so first we'll go to this question. Find the output. Here int C comma A equals to 25. So A value is 25 here. Now C equals to printf percentile D comma A. So what is the C value? What is the C value will be assigned? Anyway, before going into C value, first this printf statement has to execute, no? So it will be executed and it has to print A value, that is 25 will be printed first. After that C equals to, what is C equals to? That means printf means here it will take percentile D A. That means what is A value it will consider? What is A value? 25. So how many symbols it has? That answer. So how many symbols it is? Totally 2 symbols. So your C value will be equals to 2. Now here let us suppose if I have something like 356. So 356, totally 3 values. Like this it will consider the count. Count of number of symbols here. So C value will become 2 here. So print of percentile D C. What is C value? 2. So it has to print the output as first A then C, that is 25 comma 2. So the answer is B. So like this it will consider. So if you write another statement like this, print of percentile D something like A comma A, let us suppose for this program. So what is C value then? So percentile D, what is percentile D here? 25. Here one more percentile D, A value. What is A value? 25. So totally how many symbols? 4. So C equals to 4. Like this it will consider. Now if you add something like slash n, so totally 4, slash n is 1. So totally 4 plus 1, your C value will become 5. Like this it will consider whenever you write a statement like this. So assigning a printf statement to a variable, how it will consider. So this is the procedure. So like this you can find. Now coming to the question number 41. Which of the following condition checks will print 10 twice? So here, which one if I add, so that this output will be printed like this. 2 times of 10 comma 10. Like this it has to print. So which of the following is correct? So we'll see this one. So first, if what I need to include here, A, B, C or D. So if I include A, let us up, if A double equals to 10, if I write like this, what happens, we'll see. So if A double equals 10, what is A value 10? 10 double equals 10, relational. So it is true. So that's why it will print percentile D A. That means 10 will be printed. So it comes out of the block. That means A is printing only once. So this is not the answer. Now if I take this one, A less than or equals to 10. That means 10 less than or equals 10. Yes, it is true. It is not less than but equals. So 10 less than or equals 10 equals. So true. And it will print 10 only once. So this answer is not correct. If we see this one, if of printf. So what is this printf value? Printf slash n percentile d. I explained no already. So slash n count is 1. Percentile d. What is a value? 10. So 1 comma 0, so 2 symbols, 2. So 1 plus 2 totally 3. So here you will get total 3 here. So once again, printf slash n is a 1 count. What is percentile D? The value A, 10. So 10 means 1 0, 2 symbols. So 1 plus 2, which is 3. So if 3, which is a non-zero, so it will print 10 once. But remember this point, if you write printf, this one here, it will print first 10. It will print first 10. Then the condition is true. Again it come here. Now it will print again 10. So 10 you will get 2 times here when you take this option. This you need to remember. First in the if condition, it has to print this one. A value, what is that? 10. Then the condition is true. That's why it is printing 10. So this is a process happens if you write printf in if condition. So the answer is C. So coming to the question number 43, what will be the output of the following arithmetic expression? So arithmetic expression, here we have plus, multiplication, then percentile, which gives the remainder, then minus, then multiplication. So anyway, we need to follow operator precedence table. We'll see these operators where they are. Now here into is there, here percentile, here plus, here minus. So which you need to do first? Multiplication, you have multiplication two times you have, and percentile. If I have more than one, I need to go for left to right. I'll follow this now. So multiplication, then percentile, then this multiplication, after that again this also left to right, this one I need to consider. So this multiplication first, then this, like this I'll go. So first multiplication, 3 into 2, so 5 plus 3 into 2, which is 6, percentile 10, minus 8 into 6. Next percentile, 6 percentile 10, so if I'm divide 6 with 10, the remainder is 6 only. So here 5 plus 6 minus 8 into 6. Then the third one is this multiplication, 8 into 6, that is 48. Here 5 plus 6. Next is fourth plus, so 5 plus 6 11, minus 48. So final operation, minus 37. So the answer is minus 37. Option A is the correct answer. So this is a sum theory question. Difference between structure and union. So of course D is not the right answer. There is no difference, it is given. We can define functions within structures but not within a union. We can define functions within union but not within a structure. So these two statements are contrasting, which are not at all true. So only the difference we'll find in structure and union is the way memory is allocated. In structure, we will allocate the memory for each individual variable separately, whereas in union, we'll allocate common memory. So that is the main difference in structure and union. So answer C is correct. So coming to the question number 45. Why structures are used? Structures can be used to hold different data types. Yes, we'll hold different data types in structure. You can write like this struct. You can write something like int A, something like char B, something like float, something C, like this. Anyway, you can write. So here you can use to hold different data types, to have pointers to structures. Yes, we can have pointers to structures, to assign one to another. We can assign like this also. So the answer is all the above. So the option D is correct answer. We'll see some more questions in the next video lecture. Thank you.